Hello, today we are going to review another op-amp and diode circuit. Without further ado, let's start with analyzing the circuit by assuming the input voltage Vi is greater than zero. In this scenario, the positive input voltage is applied to the inverting terminal of the op-amp through RG. This will forward bias the diode D1 and at the same time push the op-amp output to swing to negative voltage. The op-amp output will swing to its negative saturation limit because V minus terminal is greater than V positive terminal. Remember that V minus is inverting terminal and V positive is non-inverting terminal. This negative output will also put the diode D2 into reverse bias. Therefore, we will have a following simplified circuit. As you can see here, the op-amp feedback network is simplified to a resistance network with a star configuration, containing R1, R2, and R3. From the circuit analysis course, you may remember that a star or Y network can be converted to a delta or pi network. In this star network, since R1, R2, and R3 have the same resistance values, which is 5 kilo ohm, then the delta network resistor will be identical, but with 3 times of the star resistance, which in this example will be 15 kilo ohm. Here is the circuit's final configuration for Vi greater than zero. As you can see, the circuit simplified to an inverting op-amp amplifier with a feedback resistance of 15 kilo ohm and without any change on input resistance RG, which is 10 kilo ohm. Pay attention that the 15 kilo ohm resistance, which is transferred to the inverting terminal, will not affect the circuit gain and output voltage, since it has a zero voltage at its both terminals. One terminal is directly grounded and one terminal is virtually grounded. And also, the 15 kilo ohm transferred to the output will not affect the circuit gain, since it is now appeared as a load at the output of the op-amp. So here is the relationship between input and output voltages. Before we continue, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Your support will help this channel to grow and encourage me to create more content. Thank you, and back to the video. Now let's assume the input voltage is smaller than zero. Then this will put the diode D1 in reverse bias and push it to turn off. So both D1 and R1 will be removed from our analysis because there won't be any current flowing through them. At the same time, the op-amp output terminal will swing to its positive saturation limit. This is because the op-amp non-inverting terminal now appears positive potential compared to the inverting terminal. In this condition, the diode D2 will be forward biased because its anode terminal is connected to op-amp output and it's cathoded to the op-amp inverting terminal, which is virtually grounded. Here is a simplified circuit when the input voltage Vi is smaller than zero. As you can see, the resistor R2 can be also eliminated from our analysis since its both terminals have a zero potential. One terminal is grounded, and other terminal is virtually grounded. This circuit is again an inverting op-amp amplifier with following circuit input and output relationship. Now we can draw the output voltage waveform in relation to the input signal. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I also have other videos in reviewing op-amp and diode circuits, which I will put the links under the video description.